Howdy folks, welcome back to the vlog. I got news for you. I'm not doing the 20 day mark. This is actually the 21 day mark. That's right, this is 3 weeks. 3 weeks from now is my cruise. The sound you hear in the distance is my car running, because today I'm going to the air show at the Geneseo Airport. It's about an hour and 2 minutes away, so next video you'll see is probably gonna be from my iPad because it gets a lot better picture there. And well, I'll be seeing you there, and we'll see what this new experience brings. We're going to see a lot of the planes that came to the last air show at Thunder of Niagara, and, well, we just might stop at Letchworth State Park as well on the way, so we'll be seeing you then, so see you there. Well, folks, here we are. We're at the Geneseo Air Show. Like I say, it's a very nice day. You should have seen when I came in, the movie Memphis Belle B-17 bomber was coming into land. I gotta say, what a beautiful time it's gonna be here. I can already see a bunch of new planes that I've never really seen before here, so gonna be getting some great videos today, so stay tuned. So here's the gist, folks. I just got here, and as it turns out, it's not just an air show. It's kind of like an old antique auto show. Check this out. This black one, as it says, is a 1961 Chevrolet two-door sedan. Isn't that nice? It's just like my car Mavis, all nice and black. And then we got this one. Looks pretty old, but you look on the thing, it says it's a 1981 SHRE convertible. My dad could probably tell what that one is, but I gotta say, isn't that nice? Yeah. Oh, hey, check it out. That's a C-47 Skytrain up there, and if I'm not mistaken, I'm pretty sure that's Whiskey 7. And if you guys don't remember from the last air show, well, actually, I'm not gonna give that spoiler. I'll tell you guys later. Oh, check this out. Look at those World War II Jeeps. If anybody actually wants to know, those are real Willys Jeeps, for anybody who doesn't know the current Willys model. But stay tuned for more information, and we'll be right back in a little bit. Well, folks, here's one of the first military vehicles here. This is an Army M35 Army truck. 6x6, 2.5 tons. Nickname is the Deuce and a Half. And if you look here right on the side, you look at that, that says US Navy, and the symbol below it, that's the Seabees. My great-grandfather George was in the Seabees. It was a very good operation. We got another Army truck here, another Deuce and a Half here. We'll get to the other ones. Check this out around the side. If you look right here, this nifty little thing is an M60 saw. Pretty cool, huh? That's a machine gun right there. And we also got our ammo crates as well. These ones right here for 105mm cannons. Isn't that cool? Yeah. And you look right there, that is what is known as a flying box car, a cargo plane. Most famous operation for that was the Berlin airlift. And I gotta tell you, check that out. That's of the Royal Canadian Air Force with the Canada maple leaf right there. But we'll get to see more soon, so stay tuned. So here we got the next part of the tour. Check this out. This is a Willys Jeep. As are those three all the way down there. And here's something interesting for you. Look at this. If any of you don't know what this is, this, boys and girls, is a Browning M2HB 50 caliber heavy machine gun. You imagine that, a round that's 12.7mm, that is a half inch, that's as big as your thumb. You picture a bullet as big as your thumb coming at you. And this thing at the right angle can fire at a range of 7 miles. And ain't that amazing? You just look at all that. And we got more Army trucks, and check it out, camouflage netting there. What a setup. And we got some other vehicles over there. We'll get to that in a moment. Be seeing you then. Hey folks, check this out. This is my first time doing this. I'm riding in a Willie's Jeep. Just met this guy. This is Alan. This is from the Finger Lakes chapter of the Military Vehicle Preservation Association. I've never ridden in one of these before, but feels pretty incredible. And check this out, you look below you. That's a fuel tank below the driver's seat. What an amazing day it is already. I'm already wonderstruck. For a thunder jet. Airplane propeller. So Alan, how long has this association been around?
I'm not even sure. I'm relatively new to the organization. But we joined this spring and a great bunch of guys and like-minded, we're about preserving this military equipment, and we come in and it's a nice little gathering to talk about similar interests.
Now I was told that they're trying to restore that vehicle right there, the duck.
The duck, that's the museum. That's the chassis museum, all that was the duck, the fire truck. The rest of this stuff is all owned individual people with the same idea of preserving military equipment.
I see. I'm curious to ask, because of the trucks, have you ever seen any of the gun trucks from Vietnam?
I have seen them in pictures only.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, there are not many of them survived.
I gotta say, those who do recreation of them do a very good job at it.
Yes, they do.
Man, what a ride.
Enjoyed that.
That was probably the most interesting Jeep ride I've ever taken.
Really? Well, good.
Yeah, wow. What an incredible venue. I gotta thank you for that, Alan. That was incredible.
Betcha.
So, here we are, as I said. These are some of the museum's vehicles. This is an airport fire truck here. It's an older one. It's a lot smaller. And then right here, this is the DUKW, also known as the Duck, which is an amphibious truck that would have been used in amphibious landings. You've probably seen the one downtown at the Naval Park for any of those who have been there. It's all painted gray, but this is owned by the museum. They said they're trying to restore this soon. Now check this out. The one next to it is the one that I like. That right there is a Curtiss M29 Weasel, fully tracked armored personnel carrier. What you see right there is its fully amphibious kit, where it could go in the water or up to 3 feet of mud. Those things were used during the Battle of Bulge, I saw, as mobile ambulances. And you've probably seen the ones in the videos that I've shot of the parade down in Williamsville. Yeah, isn't that incredible? These things sure are amazing. We got another army truck here, and we're gonna be heading into the museum. Here's another look at the flying boxcar. And there's another army truck there. That's probably more like a 3/4 tonner. And we got the little village around here, so I'll get more video of that in a little bit. See you then. Here we have a look, everybody, just walking through the little army town. Oh, check that out. That's a Red Army one that's supposed to be. Now that's interesting. There's another Willie's Jeep. That right there is an actual Dodge 3/4 tonner truck right there. Check out some of the weapons there. I think I see a Mosin-Nagant. I see a PPSH-40. That'll be interesting. I hope I can hold that. Got other stuff. You can see there's another C-47 Skytrain right there. Over on that post over there is an F-6F Hellcat produced by Grumman. Oh, look at that. I'm pretty sure that's an 81mm mortar right there. I got the box for the shells for that. Guy in dress white, petty officer, second class, little army tents. I'm guessing that over there next to the car is supposed to be an unexploded bomb. Oh boy. You look at all this, this is just incredible, all this. I can't believe it. But yeah, it's absolutely amazing. You just gotta wonder. Absolutely stunning. But we'll continue soon. Catch ya. Check this out, folks. This is pretty funny. This is one of two things around here. It's meant to look like an unexploded dud bomb. Isn't that funny? And there's another one over there behind the staff car, but you already saw that, so. But yeah, all these tents around here holding these different weapons is so incredible. Just all of this stuff. Absolutely amazing when you look at it. Walk along, you check out all this. Absolutely incredible. This is what you see, everybody. This is what you gotta appreciate, just how much the Second World War had to it. You'd be surprised. But yeah, you look at it, another Willys Jeep. See over there an M1 Garand and an M1 Carbine. I prefer the M1 Garand because it had better stopping power. Well, there's a lot of planes in the hangar, but this right here is what you see is a Dodge 3/4 turner truck. This is something that's similar to a Jeep, it's just bigger. So, yeah. Now check this out. Oh, look at that. There's a 30 cal right there. I can tell that's a handheld because you see the cloth around it. That's where they'd hold it. We'll check that out soon and look at all the tents. That I think I see an Australian tent. You can probably correct me if I'm wrong, but you look at that. Holy smokes. This is going to be incredible. Let's go check it out. Check it out, folks. A flyover of the Memphis Belle. Listen to that baby roar. Sorry about the blur. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Okay, folks, here's the next part. We're gonna go take a look inside the museum now with all the exhibits. And then the next thing, we'll be getting over to that hangar. Oh yeah, we got a biplane right here. But here we go, we got more things to go, so let's go check it out. See ya. Check this out, folks. We got the inside of it. My God, what a setup it is in here. Check it out. P-51 Mustang, Cripes Almighty, I've seen that one. You can tell by the blue nose, that's from the fighter group, the Blue Nose Bastards of Bodney. Pretty incredible, huh? Mi-109, Spitfire, Stuka, Corsair over there. We got these exhibits in here. Check it out, we got the B-17. And look, you get a cutaway to see the inside. Sorry about the glare, you can't see it. There's a B-25 Mitchell. Yeah, we got a pilot here with all his medals. Got all the uniforms. There's a model of a Focke-Wulf FW190. I'm not sure about the variant, but I'm not going to try and guess. And more pictures of the incredible B-17. Got some uniforms here. All propaganda. Signal flags, more stuff in here. Check it out. Bombing mission stuff and archival photos. We got models here. I see the Heavy Mosquito, a Catalina, B-17, B-25, B-29, Hawker Typhoon, B-110. FW-190, another FW-190, Thunderbolt, M-109, the B-26 Marauder, that's the HS-129, Corsair, A-26 Invader, Hellcat, Warhawk, Mustang, C-47, a lot of bigger models. And then there's the Wright Flyer, B-17 up there. Got a bunch of Army caps here. Got more uniforms and stuff in here. Oh, check this out. Good old Whiskey 7. We'll be seeing that old girl soon. Go check out the briefing room. Look at all this. Shows you how to do signaling. Here's some of the weapons. There's the good old M1 Garand. The M1 Carbine. The Thompson submachine gun. Colt M1911 pistol. This is all the gear that they carry. Look at that setup on that mannequin. Look at all that. Got a bunch of the other gear and all that. And check this out. Map of the invasion area. And here's the big map, showing the Piccadilly Circus in the middle. We had glider routes. We had paratrooper routes. And you look right here. This was Whiskey 7's target, Sainte-Marie-Glisse. These were the drop zones here, 101st Airborne here, in Vieilleville. There's Carentin. Pointe du Hoc with the Rangers set up. And there's the Vieilleville-sur-Mer. Carville-sur-Mer should be somewhere over here. Aramanche. Oistaham. And the Orne River Bridge and the Caen Canal will be over here. There's Bayou, and there's Caen. The whole operation, absolutely incredible. Amazing. Well, we got more memorabilia and stuff. We got pins and stuff, and a couple of lamps, and we got casings of ammunition here. Incredible. Yeah. And the light simulator. Check this out, folks. Lego stuff. And all bricks. Oh man, look at all this stuff.
But at the same time, I have so many.
Powered stuff at that, too.
You know.
Absolutely incredible. Corsair, B-17, and the people eat lightning. Oh, and check that out. A little micro train coming out of the tunnel. That's absolutely amazing. Got more models here, folks. Everybody, brace yourselves for this. Check this out. Look at these two. These are reproductions of two crazy aircraft. The one you see right here is of the Heinkel HE-162 Volksjäger. Excuse me, Volksjäger. The People's Fighter. Jet fighter from 1945. This plane supposedly only got one kill during the war, and that was during 1945 when it shot down a Spitfire. My God, I gotta say, if that's a reproduction, that was very convincing when I first saw it. There's a searchlight and a Jeep over there. And then look at this next one. That right there is a reproduction of the Yokosuka Oka. Japanese for cherry blossom, the man-flying rocket bomb. Imagine you seeing that coming at you at more than 600 miles an hour along the water, and you're unable to shoot it down because it's so small. Only one time did this thing ever sink a ship was when it hit the destroyer Manor L. Abley in 1945 off Okinawa and blew the ship in two. That's a scary thing. Both of these are so incredible. I can't believe it. Okay, folks, here we go. Into the next part, we're going into the hangar. Oh my, my. Check this stuff out. Hey guys, you probably recognize some of these were some of the planes that were at Thunder of Niagara. Like there's the Warhawk by the Flying Tigers. There's the Era Cobra with the test on it. Oh, there's a lot of things here. There's the Corsair we saw. Oh, boys and girls, check this out. Look who it is. It's old Quicksilver. This is my first time actually seeing her on the ground and like not in the air. Oh, beautiful with the D-Day stripes. Here's the test. Oh my gosh, absolutely amazing. Such beautiful, beautiful aircraft. There's a Tomahawk, the British version. Yeah, and you look, there's those sweet 650 cal machine guns. Here's another video of Miles, folks. Let's see just how many I can name with this. The Gloucester Meteor, ME262 Schwalbe or Swallow. I see that is actually a Bearcat. What is that? The Messerschmitt P1099. I have never seen that one. Probably a Luft X model. Skytrain. Trojan. Texan. Devastator Torpedo Bomber. Zero. That's the Nate. The Val. The Typhoon. FW190. Ventra. That is a, that's the Dinah. Lockheed Hudson. Blenheim. Is that a, that's like a Ryden. There's a Roof. There's the Duck. Kingfisher. The Rado AR-196. A lot of other things. Got the, you can see the M110 and all that. All these are basically labeled. I'm just doing my best. Yeah, there's a lot of this stuff. Now let's see if we can find the shop, shall we? Well, folks, we're out of the museum, so turns out the shop is actually out there with the tents. We're gonna start heading towards the big tents, I was told. And look at that. The Curtis Tomahawk, the British version of the Warhawk, is starting to get ready, so we're gonna see a lot of stuff out there, so. Let's go, shall we? Well, folks, here we are. We're actually at the air show part of the air show. We're gonna check all these things out. And my God, there is a lot of them to check out. Not including the porta potties. So, let's take a look. Let's see what we got. This right here looks like a Piper, probably a, yeah. No, because that's the grasshopper over there. Let's see what it says, shall we? It says, an Arancha L16 replica converted from Civilian 7 AC Champ. Well, that's interesting. Planes flying at such low speeds and still able to do stuff. There's a glider over there. My grandfather used to fly those. He enjoyed it. I wish he could still do it again. Right now, we mainly just got civilian aircraft here, so I'll let you know when there's any updates or any more interesting aircraft, so let's continue on. Well, folks, there's the first highlight. You're seeing right there, that is the Piper Grasshopper. That is an American reconnaissance aircraft from World War II. Here's a fascinating story for you. One of the last dogfights, which was a plane-on-plane engagement in the air, happened over Germany in 1945. It was actually between a plane like this, a Grasshopper, and a German Fiesler Fi-103 Storch, or Stork. They were the people in the Grasshopper. Basically what they did, they were flying around and they saw the Storch flying below and they decided to go on after it. So what they did was they opened the side door here and they started firing at it with their pistols. And they made some passes on them before they actually scored hits and the plane tumbled out of the sky. And then when it came, they found the surrendered German crew. The next one you're gonna see is a highlight that's civilian. Check that out. I've also seen that in the James Bond movies. That is a personal seaplane. pretty strange how it looks so much like a boat, you know? But that's just incredible. And we're moving on now. Also got plenty of light military aircraft here. But just wait until we get up to the big ones. They're gonna really like that. Let's go. Well, folks, here are some of the aircraft that we saw at the air show at Thunder of Niagara several weeks ago. But hey, take a look at the left. There, of course, is the movie Memphis Belle. I loved going in that thing. That thing is such a beauty inside. And Whiskey 7 happens to be over there. You'll see here in a few moments. We're gonna check out these planes right here. And I recognize these planes like the back of my hand. One this right here. This is a Grumman TBM Avenger torpedo bomber. There were dozens of these things in the Battle of Midway. All but one were shot down by the enemy. And that may have been, but that opened the way for our Douglas SBD Dauntless dive bombers to come in overhead and bomb the living hell out of the Japanese carriers and sunk four of them. Last time I saw one of these was on the carrier Intrepid, and that was 4 years ago. Hey, look at how big they are. Check this out. Oh, look at that. Inside the torpedo bay, there's a thing to look like a torpedo. I wonder, though. That actually feels like an actual decommissioned torpedo. Or how Bugs Bunny would say it. Looks like a torpedo. But you come back here. The main thing was that turret right there that had the 50 cal machine gun. I'm pretty sure that's a 30 cal right there. So down here, this little slit down here, what has another machine gun in the belly. And you can look inside the belly right here through this window. Here, we'll go around the other side. That right there is the tail hook for when they come in to land. Imagine just how they had to do all the wires for that. And you look at the cockpit up there. That's incredible, all that. And you take a look inside here. And here's all the business end. Here's where one of the gunners would be down here, although only later models had the gun that was down there. And then over there would be where they dropped the torpedo, and you could see the torpedo right through there. I apologize if you can't, but and that's where the turret gunner sat. So yeah. Quite an incredible aircraft, would you say? Now over here, here's another interesting one. Here's another Grumman Avenger, also from the Navy. This has a darker color. Dude, look at that. That shows all the bombs and torpedoes that it dropped. And it even says on the names of the islands. Marcus Atoll, Wake Island. There's Macon Atoll, Kwajalein, Wojay. Malolet, Truck Lagoon, Saipan, Iwo Jima, and Okinawa.
I was looking at that. That was awesome. I was looking at
it. Alright, so we're going to continue. And now you look over here. Here's the next highlight of the tour. That right there is a B-25 Mitchell medium bomber. God, isn't that a beauty? All silver. It's got the light blue. Funny thing. It says takeoff time on that. That's pretty interesting. These things were actually used to be launched off of the carrier Hornet in 1942 for the Doolittle raid on Japan. Over half of them ditched in the ocean. That's pretty incredible how you see all these. Very similar to a B-17, like the Memphis Belle over there. But this is a medium bomber, so it couldn't carry as much, but it still was a very good thing. So you imagine it's a quite incredible aircraft. Obviously there are stairs to people go up in, and there's the sting part of it, the 250 cal machine guns in the tail. But yeah, quite an incredible little aircraft, would you say? Absolutely astonishing. That's why the Mitchell is a very favorite bomber of mine. Just a quick highlight before we continue on. Those over there are two helicopters. One of them is a medevac. I don't think it's Mercy Flight, but the one over there is Red Cross. There's a, that's a Black Hawk right there, a very famous U.S. Army helicopter. Oh, I hear a plane running. I wonder what's running. Oh, it's a biplane. So, we're gonna continue on, and we're gonna check out these two aircraft next. So, let's go. Well, everybody, for anybody who didn't listen for the Thunder of Niagara part of the vlog, this beautiful aircraft right here is a T-47 Skytrain built by Curtis in Buffalo. This is Whiskey 7, and as it was discovered, this very lucky aircraft was the lead aircraft in the second wave of the 82nd Airborne's operation of the D-Day invasion on the morning of June 6, 1944. And it flew over St. Mary-Glace. To think it was the lead plane in the second wave. Second wave was actually a lot more successful than the first wave because a lot of them overshot the drop zone and landed in a town. If you ever want to watch something about that, to learn more about it, watch the movie called The Longest Day by that was produced by Daryl F. Zanuck in 1962. We're moving on, and of course, here's that other big bad baby. This is the movie version of the B-17 Flying Fortress Bomber Memphis Belle. Pretty beautiful, isn't it? As you'll probably have seen in my Thunder of Niagara video, people get a chance to go up inside and to think how one of my ancestors flew as a waste gunner on one of these things. Absolutely incredible. But let's continue to move on, and we'll hopefully see these elegant ladies another time. So here we are, folks. We're moving along swiftly here. Check it out. We got the Deuce and a Half truck right there. We're moving along swiftly with a lot of these aircraft. I got some news for you, folks. You're going to see an interesting one over here, so walk along, seeing the aircraft take off along the runway. Pretty incredible here with all that stuff going on here. What I wanted to show you now is, ladies and gentlemen, you look at the plane right there with the black nose. That right there, everybody, that is an Aichi A1D1 Val Japanese dive bomber. This, everybody, is a Japanese aircraft. Now, I'm not sure if this is a reproduction or not, but that is something you just don't see every day. To think that is an Aichi Val dive bomber. That's incredibly. Look around. Look at all that. An elegant white aircraft with the black nose and the red suns. You know, it's funny. This thing had a very big major drawback to it during the Second World War. That's why it was replaced with the, I think it was the Judy, I can't remember. But you look at right down under there, those wheels are fixed landing gear, so these things are very slow and sluggish. So they could be easy prey for US fighters. But we look next to it, and we see another incredible dive bomber. This is the Douglas SBD Dauntless, the famous bomber that won the Battle of Midway in 1942. Its big brother, the Curtiss SB-2C Helldiver, could carry more than twice as much as this, but you still gotta appreciate the incredible feats that these planes managed to pull off. In fact, during Operation Torch, in North Africa in 1942, this aircraft used depth charges to bomb the guns at Fort Laoti, which is near the Kasbah at Rabat in Morocco. So they helped the destroyer units come up. And then next to it, we see a few trainer aircraft. One of them is.
We'll go ahead and get this run down through.
What's that? got a text in here. Everybody's getting things moving. And over there, you can see that from the other air show. There's Mad Max, the red-tailed Mustang. We got another British aircraft over there. Like I said, I can't remember. We got other planes, so we're gonna keep moving on. They're incredible.
Time to get your autograph, get a picture with them.
T6 Texans coming in.
So there is plenty of opportunity to get up and chat.
Perfect formation.
Get all of our aircraft in for a few flybys. Thank you.
course, that wasn't Scooter Yoke, and I should probably start off the air show by the standard air show announcer announcement that anything I say that happens is purely coincidental. I'm following the schedule here, and of course, we shuffle things around quite a bit. See the CP War truck out there watering down our runways. Unlike other air shows you go to, our runways are made of grass. The greatest show on turf, ladies and gentlemen, and we're so glad you're here.
Quicksilver again, call sign Scooter. Well, folks, here's a recap of the air show. It's not even 1:30 p.m., but I gotta say it's smoking hot. I'm about to exit now. Next stop you're gonna see me in is Letchworth State Park, which is a few miles away. So a lot of interesting things. Just a recap. I apologize that Val dive bomber that you're gonna be seeing off of my iPad isn't actually a Val. It's off of an A6 Texan. But I gotta say, they did a very good job. There are only a few Vals left in the world, and there are no Kates, which all... In fact, that plane was actually one of the planes that took part in the movie Tora 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 to represent the attack of Pearl Harbor. But yeah, it is way too hot out to stay here any longer, so I'm gonna go to Mount Morris, check out a little shop, and then go to Letchworth to check out the new bridge. So, but yeah, I mean, today was fun, so I'm gonna finish that and then start heading home. So, gotta tell you, it was fun, and I hope you enjoyed this video. So, I'll get back a little bit with Letchworth. I'll show you the new bridge if possible, and I will see you in the next, I should say, 6 days actually, because that'll be the 15-day mark. So, peace out. Well, folks, here we are on the last leg of our tour. We are in Letchworth State Park, and as you can see, right there is the Glen Iris Inn, which used to be an actual inn here. And we are on our way to this building, which is the museum, and we'll take a look at the gorge later. So let's go check things out, shall we? Haven't been here in a long time. All right, folks, so we're out of the museum. We're gonna go inside the Glen Iris Inn now, and then we're gonna get a chance to see the waterfalls and the new railroad viaduct. So let's go check things out, see if there's anything good. Probably won't videotape anything, so just a little heads up for y'all. Peace out. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the next part, we get to see one of the best parts of Letchworth, the gorge and the falls. Let's check this out. There they are. Pretty incredible, isn't it? Well, everyone, here we are in Letchworth. I'm enjoying myself a little ice cream sandwich and a little pop, and, well, here's something that you should see. That right there is the new steel arch bridge for the Norfolk Southern Railway. They took out the old 1875 viaduct that was built by the Erie back in 1875. It's a shame that they had to tear it out, but I guess you can't stop progress, so. Right now I'm just sitting, eating, and just waiting for a train to go by. I just wanted to see one go by at a faster speed on this viaduct, so I'll sit and wait for a little while, and then if one doesn't come by a certain time, then I'll just go, so. But this is Letchworth. You can see the Upper Falls there, and up there along that ridge used to be a stretch of track for the Pennsylvania Railroad, and a lot of things have changed since then, and so that's really all that can be said. So enjoy it while it lasts, and this is what we get, so yeah. What a stunning change. Here's a closer look at the bridge, everyone. You can see the areas where the abutments used to stand for the old one that would have been right next to it, but now there's nothing but an archway, so all that really can be said is we will miss that old bridge, and still waiting for a train to come across, so I'm not going to stay much longer because I'm going to have to be heading home soon, so take a good long look, everybody. That's what Letchworth has turned into. Oh boy. Unbelievable this is.